50 to the bar, right? 50. Can anyone watch a stopwatch? 50? Can anyone do a 50 to the bar? That was a healthy 70. 50. As I lay in the earth.
That should be the. That's the.
As I lay. Well, okay, but it sounded a bit too fast.
Okay,
sounded
could be.
Bit, sounded a bit spirited away.
Yeah, rushed.
Rushed.
Yep.
Could it be? Just a bit more tender, not quite so.
As I lay in the early sun, stretched in the grass, I thought upon my true love, my dear love, who has my heart forever, who is my happiness when we meet, my sorrow when we sever.
Get what you're saying, because mm-hmm. it's just too fast.
Yep.
So 50, I would say, is a guide. It needs much more rubato
yep.
from both of you in order to get the sense, especially when you start a word like gentle, when I moody turn. I mean, these aren't standard English words. They're quite difficult to understand. So you have to help us with lots of rubato. And don't you are beating him to the notes sometimes, you rush him. So would you just take your time with this song? I'm saying keep it to 50.
Yes.
But will you follow him more?
Yep.
Do what you want, right? Don't do what you rehearsed, do what you want.
Okay.
As I lay in the early sun, stretched in the upon my true love, my dear love, who has my heart forever, who is my happiness when we meet, my sorrow when we sever. She is of high when I do burn, gentle when I moody turn, brave when I am sad and heavy.
Simplicity of this song. I think it's a mistake to pull it around too much, but I think maybe there has to be a little bit more give and take with it just to get the text across. And it's, you're not going to disturb the feeling of the song
yes.
by emphasizing words like gentle. Mm-hmm. Just taking a little bit more rubato on gentle when I moody turn. Mm-hmm. So can we try it again? And you had the right idea. To be a bit stronger with it all. Brave when I am sad and heavy, and laughter when I am merry. So that's obviously it picks up. And so I lay and dreamed and dreamed. You know, take some risks with the rubato a bit more. All of this music, this English music, this Ivor Gurney, it has to sound extremely improvised. Literally like it's been made up on the spot. And anything that sounds production line is not English. I don't know what it is, but it's not English. And the whole point is that it's meant to sound like you're walking the Gloucestershire countryside in a breeze, and it's just like you're swept along in this bucolic landscape. And so anything that sounds repetitive is not the right sound. It just doesn't sound right to me, and I'm not quite sure yet what it is. But I want you to take the reins with the words a bit more.
Okay.
Tell us the story as much as you can.
As I lay in the early sun.
As I lay in the early sun. You have to be more expressive.
Yes. As I lay in the early sun, stretched in the grass.
That's what it is. When you listen to people like John Mark Ainsley sing, stretched in the grass. You know, words like stretched, stretch it. he's given you a minimum, what do you call them, half notes. So play with it, stretched in the grass. Mm-hmm. Tell us physically what you're doing. You're lying in the grass. Mm-hmm. That was much better though.
As I lay in the early sun, stretched in the grass, I thought upon my true love, my dear love, who has my heart forever, who is my happiness when we meet, my sorrow when we sever.
Right, that's lovely. I wanted you to, when you have a repetition, my true love, my dear love, there has to be something more, my dear love. It can either be a piano, a withdrawing, mm-hmm. my true love, my dear love. You know, you have to take advantage of every single opportunity of expressing a repetition, my true love, my dear love. You know, just something you choose. Because it's such a short song and you have to pack it full of everything. Yeah. It's like an overstuffed picnic basket. You know, you have to get everything in there because you're going to be short of something. And who is my happiness when we meet? Who is my happiness when we meet? Express that because he's given you the opportunity to do it.
Yeah.
So I don't know if John Mark has recorded this. I'm sure he has. So have a listen to it at some point. Anyway, for now, we're listening to your beautiful voice do this. So let's just get some more expression into
yep.
that. Start from the beginning, please.
As I lay in the early sun, stretched in the grass, I thought upon my true love, who has my heart forever? Who is my happiness when we meet? My sorrow when we sever.
Right. Who has my heart? It's too quick. Who has my heart?
Uh-huh.
All right. Not who has my heart?
It's too
quick. Who has my heart? So you don't have to hit it hard.
Yes.
You can hit it. Has support.
Yes.
Has my heart forever. Because uh-huh. that's the more expressive than heart.
Yep.
Ever. Forever is
forever.
More expressive. Has my heart forever.
Would you do it with the R or with the word forever?
Oh, you just leave it. Forever.
Forever?
Like it's not there.
Okay.
There are one or two singers of yesteryear, English singers, who do put strange R's on the ends of words like ever. And I've never understood why.
No, I meant in between. Would you sing forever or forever?
I think on that it's a melisma, so it's forever. Forever!
Okay.
Not forever or forever.
Yep.
Forever! But it's getting there, it's really. And take your time to find the space for that G sharp. Is it G sharp? Yes. You know, take your time to think that note before you get to it so it's not, you're not banging into it.
Hasty.
Have a think where that note is in your placement and
okay.
your support. I thought upon my true love.
I thought upon my true love, my dear love, who has my heart forever, who is my happiness when we meet, my sorrow when we sever. She is on fire when I do burn, gentle when I would return.
I noticed quite a lot of arm stuff going on. So, can I just ask you not to do it?
Yes.
You can.
Of course, when you sing in performance, you're going to have to say it. But just select which word you're going to do it for. Gentle, that's fine. Who is my happiness when we... my sorrow when we sever. When we sever. Sever. She is all my fire when I do burn. Gentle. You know, something like that. But if you're doing it too much, then actually it's your body that should be working, not your arms. And I know I do it too. It's a habit.
Yes.
Use the mirror as much as you can. That was so lovely with that heart forever. Who is my happiness when we meet? Go from my sorrow when we sever.
My sorrow when we sever.
Dreamy music, so can you make it dreamy there? Just something very beautiful and wind swept here, breeze swept. Would you mind trying something just there that makes it an echo of what we've heard, like a dream state? Would you mind going for merry? You don't have to sing it. Go from merry again, you don't need to sing. I mean, you know, look, I'm sorry, English people are totally lazy with their own language, so please don't think I'm having a go at you not being, you know, Lithuanian, but I think you're doing a brilliant job singing this in English, and thank you for doing an English song, and you're singing it so beautifully. But you are going to have to help us with unusual words like wield. Some people go wheeled, but I think that's a little strange. And so the day wheeled on. Something like that, if you could help us with that. I also thought you needed to give a little bit more voice, not volume. And so I lay and dreamed. Make your vowels very, very long.
Yes.
Would you mind going from your beautiful piano phrase that you now play so beautifully?
Thank you.
When you paint like that, and then when you get to sing Tamino, it'll all make sense.
Yes.
Yeah. It's all part of the same process of small brush strokes like that make all the difference when you've got a phrase that's doing that. Yes, you've got, this is practice.
Yeah.
Yes. Sure. While all the birds with thought like mine express mine.
Yes.
What, just before, while all the birds.
While all the birds with thought like mine were singing to the sun.
Beautiful. It really suits you, this song. Really fun. Fidèle by Duparc.
Oh, dude.
second, which I
yes,
which I wanted to. If you feel like doing that, I mean, pockets are a thing, I suppose. But if you can just be aware to keep your wrists relaxed when you feel that happening, and the position is more that rather than that, because
yes,
that creates tension in the shoulders and the neck, and you're going like that, and suddenly, so. If anything, it's just, if anything, you're planting your tree roots into the floor for the final
yes
moment. And that you're sort of like, ha-ha, you know, a big
yeah
moment rather than anything with their arms. Armography, not good.
Yeah.
But other than that, I thought your control was absolutely superb. And I thought it was Desprez, not Desprez. Desprez at the beginning.
Oh, I thought it's accent aigu. No?
Well, it is, but it's quand dans les prés.
Okay, it's
not
too
les
close
prés.
It was
les,
a bit
les
German
prés. Yes. Well, it was pretty good. Qui dans les prés en fleurs.
Mm-hmm.
German, but your French is very good. Se perd sous les noirs. Les noirs alliés. I've also heard noirs alliés, but I mean.
No.
There are two schools of thoughts about that. I've heard French people say noirs alliés, and I've heard people go, no, 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 no. Which is it? It could be either. Noir allié.
Noir
allié, you see?
But Bernac, Bad Bernac writes without.
I know, but it's, I think it's.
She's right, there's a school of thought that Bernac and
the old school
were a little bit off the mark.
Yeah.
I think
if you should have lied it, les noirs alliés, yeah. I think that's the current way of doing it.
Yeah.
So
I can only explain one thing, linguistic, because the word is of not French and Latin descent. It's of Gaelic, not Gaelic, or Germanic.
Yeah.
Germanic words beginning with H are never, should be never connected.
But in French they are.
The S.
Yeah, yeah.
Does. And it is les prés, isn't it? Not les prés.
Yeah.
Les
yeah
prés. It's quite open, les prés. Yes,
and
I agree.
It breaks the whole sound that's going on.
Qui dans
yes
les prés?
Qui
dans les prés?
Qui
dans
les
prés? Présent fleurs.
Fidèle.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It's a bit German.
Well,
not yeah,
you're doing really well,
though. Yeah.
This is, again, one of the things that's very difficult. Mm. Having lived in France for 40 years, trust me, it's terrifying.
Yes.
and you're almost right.
You're almost right.
You're almost right in the sense of thinking that there are two schools of thought.
Yeah.
If you get three French people together, you
I know.
Yes.
It's a nightmare when you get the
thank
three
you
London French coaches coming
yeah
to a Wigmore Hall recital, because
oh
they spend the whole time arguing afterwards.
Yeah.
Yes, thank
yes
you.
Seriously beautiful,
yeah,
wasn't it? Trèfle de thym, sol et plein soleil, chante les abeilles, volage. I love the way you sang that. That was lovely. Volage. That was really lovely. But I think let's just do the end, because
yes
that's the bit where the sound got a little hard.
Yeah.
And I think you need to think more bel canto for that. Don't try and force it. Just think more Carreras.
Okay.
Or my favourite, Corelli. just more gentle. Don't hit it.
Yes.
Just think more lyrical. I know it says avec chaleur, but that doesn't mean violence. It means just with passion.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
Yes.
Heat. Just for this exercise. I think what it might do is you might use your breath a bit better. It's perfectly possible to do.
Yeah, I can do it. It's just I'm cheating. I'm trying to cheat.
You can cheat after. You can breathe after meh, if you want. Yes, so I think just try it and try to make the vowels really quiet in the nose here because it's ah.
Yes.
They're not too but ah. Try that. Think getting it in the squillo position forward, not in the throat. It feels a bit throaty to me.
Yeah.
It needs to be a bit more.
Yeah.
Right? No consonants. Just think Italian vowels here. Less, none of that. Relaxed. Mouth doesn't do anything. Your lips, when you sing, all they do is form consonants and occasional assistance with a change from a, e, o, but the lips don't do anything. All right?
Especially
the
bottom. About it.
I know. That I'm your mirror for today. But that was so much better. Your tone wasn't so hard. To be rude. I don't mean to be rude. But it had a more of a sort of movement, elasticity to it, which is what I'm aiming for.
Just
try again. And just be conscious of your mouth is relaxed. Mm-hmm. And use your tummy instead.
Yep.
Try to tip the sound forward into the I sound.
Yeah.
Que ton plus beau sourire. I know why you're doing it, because you're preparing the sourire going sourire. Oué, not sourire. Que ton plus. Sorry, would you give me a. Que ton plus beau sourire, same vowel,
beau sourire.
You see, ooh and e are very close neighbours.
Yes.
Oui, oui. Tongue, same position. Oui, oui, sourire, forward. If your su is forward, your e will be forward.
Yeah.
All right? Good. Que ton plus beau sourire.
Que ton plus beau sourire. Que ton plus beau sourire.
It's gone back. Sourire. Just go do that for me. Open your tummy. Strong tummy.
Oh.
Space in the back of the throat. space in the back of the throat. So just think about the vowels that unite the high one.
Yes.
That they are all linked, and the position
yes.
is very important. That bo, plus, oui. You know,
yes.
they are the same vowel, they just switch the position inside the
yes.
mouth. Do you want to try with the words this time?
Yes.
Just that phrase, and have a good think about keeping the Italian vowels very pure. Ooh,
uh-huh.
bo, ooh.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh is a very safe vowel to sing on.
Mm-hmm.
One of the safest.
Thanks.
Peton plibo.
Peton plibo.
Position that you need to aim for the E vowel.
I feel it. It's just hard.
It's the same position.
Yeah.
It's that wherever that slot is, that's where the E, and it's the E is even more forward. But you know, I'm not going to meddle with tenors and their position of where they find certain notes because it's different for everyone. It's a nightmare. But you've just got to go with what feels comfortable. But
yes.
be quite rigorous on yourself that all the vowels have to be quite covered. I don't mean covered as in woolly, but I just mean that there has to be nothing that pops out.
Yes.
Oh, it has to be under this sort of beautiful cupola of nothing standing out. So just in your practice,
how you would call it in English, angeglichen?
Yeah, aligned.
Aligned, yes.
Yeah, it's sort of together
yeah.
in one sound.
Yes.
So just do that. I won't beat you to death over that now. But because I'm not going to touch the beginning. It's completely beautiful. So I think you're doing so well. Thank you for singing this.
Thank you.
Thank you.